Hi student, welcome back. Today we are going to learn from 5 science chapter 2.5 regarding food processing technology. So fresh raw food is healthier, correct or not? If you eat the pasar, you buy your food from the pasar, the green vegetable and the fresh fruit, it is a lot healthier rather than if you buy canned food or the dried ikan bilis or the freezing food that had been frozen. If you want to compare, it is much better to eat it raw. I mean not eat it raw, but of course by cooking, okay? Okay, so food processing technology. Okay, first of all, it's by cooking, correct or not? This is the main process because we are not like cow where we can like sit on the road and eat the grass. So better because the cow stomach is different. There are 4 types of different stomach in a cow that help them to digest the cellulose from the tree, from the grass. And we as a human, we cannot eat grass because if you eat little bit, then you won't die lah. I think eat little bit should be alright. If you eat a lot, then you still need to eat rice, right? How good it is that if we become like cow, correct or not? Then we don't need to work so hard. Don't need to go McDonald's, we can save a lot of money by sitting on the beside the road and eat the grass. But we as a human, we usually need to cook, okay? Especially for vegetable that has cellulose. We want to cook it to break the cellulose, then you can eat it soft, correct or not? So the vegetable you take it is soft. If not, you'll be like, okay? So food is processed by frying, grill, smoking, braising, and so on, a lot of these things. Example of food product that is being processed like chicken curry, fried fish, grilled chicken, and so on. So this is by cooking. I think you guys know. If you don't know about this, you can ask your mom. Fermentation. So fermentation is to do what? Still remember or not? Last time we learned before. I'm not sure we learned before or not. Okay, method. Fermentation is to make the most easiest one to... Oh, here didn't write because this is a Muslim country, right? Not a Muslim country, it's the Islam as the main religion. I mean, we use fermentation to make what? To make wine. So I just put here wine. Maybe it's not taken. It's mostly used to make wine. Correct or not? When you buy wine, Carlsberg, actually Carlsberg I'm not sure, but I know wine, you need to use fermentation, red wine, white wine, and so on. So, of course, not only to make wine, you can use soy sauce, kimchi, tempeh, yogurt, and tapai. Oh, tapai also is a type of alcohol, right? Tapai. How to make this? What do we call it? Fermentation. So fermentation is a process that you want to use the action of bacteria to create the thing. Usually by glucose, we can eat it. Like rice. Rice got glucose, so we can just eat the glucose. However, now I don't want to eat rice. I want to use the rice to make a... What do you call it? Rice wine or something like that. In Chinese, there is a thing called the mai zhao. In English, maybe it's called as the rice wine. You can use the rice to make the wine. Very easy. Maybe you can just go YouTube. Maybe just take the rice, put inside the wine, put the rice, and then you put a little bit of yeast where you can buy in Tesco or Aeon. Then you just put the water and just close it for 2 months, then it will produce ethanol and carbon dioxide. Then you just make the rice wine. You can use you can make wine by using rice, grape, anything sweet lah. But mostly we use grape, right? Because grape inside grape got a lot of glucose, so sweet, right? Then they usually make it. I mean, it tastes better lah if you use grape. So I'm not going to go too deep into this, but the main process is like this. is the bottle. If we expose it to the air, and there is bacteria eating the food, then it will be raw and it will spoil, correct or not? Because let's say I put the grape, and that's and I just leave it, and after 2-3 days, the bacteria eat the grape and it becomes smelly and spoiled. Different than you put the grape and the yeast, and then you close it. The problem is the bacteria want to eat, want to do something to the thing, but it don't have oxygen because you already closed the cover. So the bacteria will continue to do its process, which is a very slow process called anaerobic respiration. It's a process of, like I would say, consuming it without using oxygen because you close it, mah. So there's no oxygen. So after a while, it will be fermented and it become a wine. Huh? So this is the thing. And I think it's healthy, correct or not? Yogurt, yogurt is healthy. Kimchi is healthy. Right? Dehydration. So you remember the word dehydration? I am dehydrated. Means I don't have enough water. Means take up the water from the food. So let's see. Dry shrimp or what? You just need to take the food and put under the sun in order to make dry food. Maybe you should do this, you know, I also want to do this, correct or not? I think maybe you go YouTube. Nowadays a lot of things we can learn by YouTube. I think they just take the orange or anything, put some sugar and dry it under the sun. And after that you can eat it. It's still nice, it's still very nice. Of course, lack of vitamin, but it is still very nice. Pasteurization. What do you mean by pasteurization? It's used to make milk and fruit juice. So how does this process occur? Okay, liquid is heated at the temperature below its boiling point to kill pathogen and then cool quickly. So for example, it depends on product. Different product got different temperature. Let's say you want to say milk, heated at the temperature of 63 for 30 minutes, temperature of 75 for 30 minutes, and then cool down immediately. Means it will, this is in the factory lah, not do by hand. It will be 63 Celsius, then suddenly become very hot. Just boil it for 15 seconds. 15 seconds, you boil it to 72 degrees. Then after faster put the, I don't know, cold wind or what, then become cold back. The reason they do this, you know or not, let's say what the, why the question asks, why the milk need to be heated 72 degrees Celsius in 15 seconds? I mean, it won't be easier, man, like you heat it for 100 Celsius. Just cook in your home, lah. Then you don't need to put in the factory. The reason they need to put in 72 Celsius in 50 seconds is to, they already do their calculation. So they don't destroy the nutrient in the food. If you just boil it, yes, there's no bacteria. But the content of the nutrient is greatly reduced. So you want to keep the nutrition in the milk, you want to do it very fast. 72 Celsius faster than echo. Then you keep the nutrient. So when we go to Speedmart and we buy the milk, we can be assured that the milk is still healthy. Okay, it's still healthy because it's being processed by pasteurization, not being cooked or boiled. You also can cook or boil, but no more vitamin. Canning, I think this one you already know. Canning, first they put it into 115 degrees Celsius to kill the microorganism, and then just seal it tight, and yep, so you got this lychee, milk, and meat by canning. Of course, every food got pro and cons, lah, correct or not? If you want to talk about preservation longer, I will say dehydration. Correct or not? This one can wait for 2-3 years, but no vitamin. Pasteurization is very good. It can keep the nutrient, but the expiry date is like very fast, correct? Not the milk maybe can last for 1 month, 2 months, not can like last for 2-3 years, right? And you need to put in the fridge. You cannot like put it outside, then it will spoil even faster. And canning, everything got pro and cons, lah, okay? Pro and cons. Freezing is good. I think you guys know because there's fridge in your home. Correct not? So why freezing work? Because bacteria need to be like in the room temperature in order to work, to respire and so on. So when it make it cold, it actually the microbe, the enzyme actually stop, and the growth of microorganism also stop because it's too cold. So it just doesn't work. So you can use freezing. I like freezing because freezing is cheap and it won't really destroy the nutrient content, correct or not? Maybe the taste is not that good lah, but I like freezing. Irradiation. Okay, so irradiation is what is something new, right, in this chapter. So food exposed to radiation like gamma ray, ultraviolet, and X-ray to kill microorganisms like Salmonella and Campylobacter. So this one is to use radiation to destroy it. So it's like a machine that it can destroy. I don't think this one is good or so, correct or not? Because radiation, yes, you destroy the bacteria. At the same time, you also destroy the nutrient. I won't recommend this method. Vacuum. We know bacteria need oxygen. So what we need to do is just take out the air so that there is no oxygen. So it will stop the food from oxidation. Nut, rice, durian, vegetable. So of course, you can stop the thing from being spoiled. And it depends, like for this durian, I never eat before, like got durian that this packaging. Because durian is wet, right? So yes, you can keep very long. But after a while, like fermentation, even without oxygen, the bacteria can evolve, or there's oxidation. So eventually, like this durian, it will spoil because the bacteria will also grow or oxidize. Unlike nuts or rice, correct or not? Well, nuts and rice, when you making a vacuum pack, it is very dry. So now the bacteria got problem. It is dry and there has no air. So the bacteria is more difficult to survive. But for this one, at least it don't have air, but at least it still has the water, vegetable, and so on. Chemical substance used in food. Okay, this one I think you guys need to know. Because we want to know the pro and cons. So let's look at this. Sweetener to make the food sweet. Malaysian, I think the whole human race likes sweet thing. Sugar, palm sugar, honey. I think this is natural, that's really good. Cakes, drink. Aspartam, sorbitol is artificial and is not good. So this one, I think this one, it got, let me see, got, what is the sweetener? Let me find. Sugar, it's mentioned here, sugar. So probably it's at here. So this Pepsi is using a sugar because this, I like Pepsi actually. And Pepsi is still not paying me money. Hopefully Pepsi will pay me money. Sugar, which is actually natural. And a lot of people complain of high calorie. And I also like to drink Pepsi, and this Pepsi is zero calorie, and they always promote zero calorie is good. But is it really good? As I can read from here, it is mentioned here got condition yang dibenarkan perisa pemanis tanpa zat aspartam, which is this one. Aspartam is the same as this one, aspartam. Wow, this is better or zero calorie. But if you Google and search, aspartam is maybe even worse than Pepsi. That's why I prefer to drink this one. Actually, both is very bad lah. But I think this one is slightly better than this one, zero calorie. This one tastes better actually. So, aspartam, if you drink this one, you won't get fat, right? Because it's zero calorie. But because aspartam, what is the side effect? Cancer, seizure, headache, dizziness, birth defect, depression. All this is the aspartam. They always promote zero calorie. Let me see. Zero calorie. I see, not zero calorie. But it's not healthy. because it got aspartame, which can cause depression, seizure, and cancer. No wonder so many people get cancer now. They always drink Pepsi, Pepsi Coke. Don't drink the, how do I say, Pepsi. Artificial drink, like zero calorie Pepsi, zero calorie Coca-Cola. This one is not I buy, this one is the student gave to me, got a birthday party, so I gave it. So I buy, but not that often, okay? Not that often. Later you say, teacher, you also drink lah, tell me don't drink, but you drink. I drink very little. I mean, one week, one can or two can, okay? Okay, antioxidant. Okay, antioxidant, which is good or bad? Slow down the oxidation of fatty, prevent fruit and vegetable from turning brown. So, this is a good thing. Okay, antioxidant, if you don't want cancer, you need to take a lot of antioxidant, like vitamin C is an ascorbic acid. Example of food, cooking oil, I prefer to write orange lah. Orange, kiwi, mango got a lot of vitamin C or not? I mean, the thing that got a lot of vitamin C is healthy. Vitamin E, margarine, and biscuit. Margarine, did they put it wrong? I think they should put butter, right? I mean, do you know that butter and margarine is different? When you go to supermarket, when you want to buy, there are two things. One is butter, one is margarine. And guess what? Which one is healthier when you go to supermarket? The butter is healthier. The one is like around 10 ringgit, one is around 5 ringgit. Sometimes 3 ringgit only, like Planta. Buy the more expensive one, okay? Don't tell your mom, don't save the money, because the cheaper, like margarine, actually it can has more, it can cause more side effect and a lot of fats compared to butter, which is more organic, if I can use the word. Better lah, huh? Better. Just buy butter rather than margarine. And you of course got a lot of vitamin E. Butane hydroxynisole. Okay, vitamin pills. So this is artificial lah. So it's not. I don't like artificial lah. I like natural, correct or not? Natural thing like fish oil or what. I think it's more natural. Okay, emulsifier. What is that? Emulsifier, a substance which do not mix such as fat and water in the food. So like when you want to make ice cream, do you know that ice cream is the combination of like some fat and water, correct or not? Because if you put the fat and the water, it will split. The fat will float, the water will go down. So there's two layers. I want to combine the oil and the water. I want to combine together. How do you want to combine that? You add emulsifier. So when you add emulsifier, it will combine it together. At first, it cannot combine because water and oil or fats. After you add emulsifier, it can combine to make like ice cream, mayonnaise, yogurt, cheese, correct or not? It's like got a lot of fat and water. Depend, improve the homogeneity and stability texture. Nice, right? Sometimes you eat ice cream, mayonnaise, yogurt, cheese, you feel it's nice because, I mean, it's mixed properly lah. Depend on how you want to cook it. Preservation. So, preservation, I think I'm very sensitive. Very, very sensitive to this thing. I'm very concerned about food because I don't want to get sick. I want to live healthily until I get old. Being healthy is one of the great investments. You don't want to earn a lot of money just to pay the doctor, right? So now as we are young, we need to take care of the health. Don't wait until you get older. Start now, okay? You live healthy, you feel happy. Preservation. Here it didn't give example, but preservation is not good. Preserve means to make the food live longer, so it can cause cancer, allergy, fetal defect means the baby got problem. That's when it's liver, kidney. That's why you got liver cancer, kidney cancer, if you eat a lot of preservation. Like, I think one of the most famous one is acid benzoic. I think that one is from sambal chili. And don't eat too much, especially the chili that you buy from supermarket. It got the too much preservation, which is not good and it can cause cancer. The pan min chili, the Chinese have to eat, the outside, all the chili, the sauce chili, I seriously think it is not good. I think we should eat the raw chili, you know, just cut the raw chili, and the raw chili is organic and rather than the sauce chili, which they put a lot of preservation. It can cause cancer, correct or not? Coloring, a lot of food coloring. Bleach can cause cancer. All these things cause cancer. Flavoring, sweetener, antioxidant. Okay, so antioxidant retard body growth, damage liver. This one is the more confusing part. I think the textbook say wrong or what is it? Because actually antioxidant is usually good. Where was I? Antioxidant. Just now I saw antioxidant. Okay, so it usually is good if natural, but here say that it retard the body growth, damage liver and kidney, rash and itching. Okay, so antioxidant food is good, but antioxidant as a preservation, which is maybe not that good because it can damage the liver, kidney, because the book mentioned like this. So I think it's a different category when we are referring to antioxidant food. I mean, you can Google it, antioxidant, if you don't believe me, or antioxidant as a preservating substance for the food. So now this one, I think they are talking about antioxidant as a chemical substance to preserve the food. So these are the effects, okay? So, but antioxidant food is good, okay? There's a few questions here and I'm going to do this in the next video, and I see you in the next video. Thank you and bye-bye.